Here we go, underway with round one. Edric Clark looking for an early start. Edric Clark is on fire right now, starting fast. Big takedown by Angel. Edric needs to be a little careful here so he's not gassing out when you really start wheeling off those punching combinations like that. Edric works his way back to the feet. Good job. Angel still holding on to the legs. Good job by Angel hooking one of the legs. We'll see if he's able to complete this takedown when he's able to do that. A lot of times when you go for these double leg takedowns, you want to grab a little bit below the butt. It's a little bit easier when you're trying to suck your opponent out from the cage.
Yeah, at this point he needs to change levels because he's a little high up. He's not going to be able to complete the takedown.
Right now he's really content on holding on to those legs, which might be a little bit of a smart idea to kind of take a little bit of the steam off of Edric, because Edric came off hot in the beginning. Referee breaks him. You can expect Edric to come and bring the pressure back on him. Nice leg kick by Angel.
That's how he's going to throw the timing off. You can't just allow Edric to walk in like that. Looks like Angel's starting to get a little bit more loose in there.
Yeah, I think Angel's every starting to get a little more comfortable in the fight. Nice leg kick again.
Edric coming forward.
Right now, both guys waiting.
Edric showing a lot of feints before he enters. I like that.
Always very important to see that in striking.
That's something you like to see out of young fighters, you know? Sometimes a lot of guys just like to walk in there, you know, and that's how you get caught. You need to set up your entries, even for your striking.
That was a 10-second bell.
Good first round. We told you the flyweights are coming out here to fight.
Yeah, Edric Clark was not playing any games, especially in the beginning of that round. Angel did a good job of controlling it by getting that takedown and avoiding that onslaught that Edric was bringing. Here we go, round two underway.
Here we go. Round numero dos.
That seemed to be a little low, but Edric seemed to shake it off. Right now, Edric seems to be losing the feints, moving in and out pretty good, but Angel's trying to cut him off with those leg kicks.
I like the feints, but you know, you gotta come with something after it. Keep on throwing empty feints. There's nothing your opponent is going to bite on.
Angel right now trying to look to level change again.
Good takedown.
Good takedown. Edric looking to get right back up.
But again, Edric bounces right back up, and he ends up on top. Good work by Edric. Angel looking to control the posture. Get up and sleep now. going for a sweep, but he's stuck. The cage has him stuck. There's nowhere to go.
A lot of times when you look for these submissions here against the cage, it could be a little tough.
Oh,
illegal kick, illegal kick.
Honestly, that didn't really land, but you got to be careful with your weapons.
Yeah, if that would have landed, it could have been big trouble for Angel.
Yeah, if that would have landed, it would have been bad for Edric.
But yeah, there are no kicks to a grounded fighter to the head. You could kick the body, but not the head.
This is not Pride.
Yeah, definitely not. Yeah, very Pride, you could launch those things. Angel trying to sweep him again. He needs to slide back down to the legs if he wants to get this takedown. Angel ends up on bottom again. Oh, Angel's able to reverse. Edric's holding on to that gi. Edric seems to be, Angel seems to be pulling guard here. Right now, Edric getting some much-needed control time here in the round. A lot of times, a lot of the judges, they like to see the guy that's on top. Ten-second bell. Looks like Edric's going to finish on top again. A good round for Edric Clark. He's able to end up on top in a lot of those scrambling, in a lot of those positions where they scrambled.
Yeah, he was doing a good job of scrambling, ending up in a better position. I give that round to Edric.
Yeah, especially a lot of the times in those grappling positions, you need to make sure that you end up on top, especially in these short 3-minute rounds. It's very important who can have that top position. Unless you're attacking relentlessly with submissions off your back, that's a different story. But that wasn't the case so much for Angel. I think he was looking to hold a little more. And when you're doing that with a guy like Edric that's just staying on top, landing little shots, that's winning Edric the round there. In Angel's corner, you got a UFC veteran, Nico Price, so I guess we'll see what kind of advice he can give to Angel. I think Angel's gonna need a big third round here.
And I'm sure he's getting some good advice, you know, on how to finish the fight, because Nico is a finisher.
Oh yeah, Nico has some crazy up kicks from the bottom, probably some of the craziest finishes in UFC history, to say the least.
So if there's anybody who's gonna help you, if there's anybody who's gonna help you find a way to finish, it's definitely Nico.
Reverse that one. Good job by Edric.
Edric's just doing a good job of every time Angel gets a hold of him. He's about to take him to the floor.
Yeah, ends up staying on top. Good job.
Good job of scrambling. He had an armbar there, but I don't think he saw it. No, watch out. Watch out. Watch out. Watch out. Put your hand in the thigh. Looks like Angel's trying to lock up Kimura here.
Yeah, Angel's trying to lock up a Kimura here.
Oh, he almost had it.
Isn't holding the wrist.
Lost control.
Edric's doing a very good job in all of these scrambling positions to end up on top.
Angel needs to work. You don't want to just accept this position and lay down.
Come on,
looking like he's trying to control the arm and go for a triangle. But Edric was onto it.
Right here, Angel seems to be accepting this bottom position a little too much. You don't want to be on your back, not shooting up any submissions, not trying to throw any punches off your back, because this is right now an easy round for the judges to score for Edric.
He has his guard open, but he's not really doing much.
He went for a little butterfly sweep there, but yeah, I agree with you. You know, he needs to try to work more. If you want to play the bottom game in MMA, you better be shooting up submissions. You better be throwing punches off your back, and you have to try to actively score and finish the fight, because the judges already see you in a disadvantageous position. So if you decide to stay here, you have to work.
And especially with these three-minute rounds, you cannot afford to let your opponent be on top of you for so long and be inactive.
He's looking for the rear naked choke. Edric's looking for the rear naked choke with 10 seconds left. Can he get the finish?
Good fight.
Angel's able to get on top, but I think too little too late there.
Good fight from Edric Clark. He did a good job. Good sign of respect right there.
Yeah, real good sign of respect by Edric.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, after three rounds of action, después de tres rounds de acción, vamos al resultado de los jueces. We go to our judges' scorecards, and they have decided your winner, su ganador, via decisión unánime, by way of unanimous decision, Edric Clark.
Very good debut for Edric. He started off very hot in that first round. He seemed to fade a little bit towards the end of the round, but he was able to pick it up again in the second round. I think his corner made some good adjustments of telling him to make sure you finish on top in those scrambles, and I think Andrew just didn't really have the answer when he was on his back.
I think him ending up and all the scrambles, always ending up on top, is what ultimately ended up winning him the fight. He did a good job, you know. He came out there hot, aggressive, and, you know, he slowed down the pace a bit towards the end, but he did definitely not slow down. He definitely had more cardio in the tank. Good win, good debut for Edric Clark.
Oh, yeah, and especially in these three-minute rounds, very important to be on top of these fights, especially if you don't have as much time to work when you're off your back and set things up. So I think it's very important, if you do end up on your back, to look for sweeps and submissions quickly. And I think Angel got stuck on the...